Hello, anatomy colleagues. This is Dr. Alsup, and in this video, we will discuss how to identify the pertinent osteology, or bony structures, for the knee and distal lower limb session. So you cannot have a session on the knee joint without talking about the bony parts that form the knee joint. Recall, the knee joint is going to be composed of two tibiofemoral articulations, which you can see here, with some of the associated structures as well as a patellofemoral articulation. So if we're looking at this anterior view of a deep joint dissection, you can see here that the patella has been reflected. It's embedded. In fact, it develops within the quadriceps femoris tendon. And when it is not reflected, it articulates with the patellar surface of the femur, which is this very patellar-shaped, smooth surface on the anterior and distal surface of the femur. So remember, smooth surfaces likely tell you there was articular cartilage located there during life due to a joint location. From this anterior view, you can only see a small peak of the condyles. So this would be the medial, this would be the lateral. I can see the fibula right here, so I know that's lateral. But I much prefer a posterior view of the femur for locating the femoral condyles, and my trick for determining which condyle is medial and which is lateral is to always look proximally and find that hard to miss head of the femur, which always faces medially. So the femoral condyle inferior to the head is the medial condyle. The lateral condyle is inferior to the greater trochanter, which is always lateral. You're likely used to this image of the patella, which fits right on that smooth patellar surface of the femur. Again, this is the anterior surface of the patella, which is always the rougher side. You can see it kind of, the bone is kind of built up a little more here. And the posterior side is the one that's actually articulating, so it will be smooth as it had articular cartilage associated with it during life. The point of the patella is always directed inferiorly. Moving to the tibia, which is important for not only the knee joint, but also the ankle joint. This is the medial and weight-bearing bone of the leg. The proximal end will be involved with the knee joint, allowing the femoral condyles to sit on their own condyles. You can see just how shallow these condyles are. So that fit between the femoral condyles and the tibial condyles is not a very tight fit. The way I quickly differentiate between the two is that the medial condyle is always on, so this is the medial condyle, and I know that because it's always on the same side as the medial malleolus or malleolus. All right, so that's always, this one will always be the medial one, this will be the lateral condyle. Again, this is the medial malleolus, which is on the medial side of the ankle joint region. You can palpate your own medial malleolus on the medial side of your own ankle. This distal and an inferior most portion of the tibia is what will actually articulate with the talus or the talus. Now on to the much thinner and non-weight-bearing fibula, which is the lateral bone of the leg. On this distal end here of the fibula, the dominant structure is the lateral malleolus, or again, malleolus. So it's less bulbous in shape and more tapered than the proximal head of the fibula. So one of the more difficult things is differentiating which side is, what's superior and what's inferior, what's proximal and what's distal. And really that lateral malleolus tends to be a little bit kind of longer and more tapered than the head of the fibula. Lastly, we get to the foot, and there are two tarsal bones we expect you to be able to identify. The superior most tarsal bone, shaded here in pink, is the talus or the talus, which when you look at its superior surface, which I just put this big T on, is almost all smooth. So the surface here is going to be an articular surface. That distal tibia will sit right here to form the talocrural or ankle joint. You can also see the talus or the talus on this from this medial view here as well. So you can kind of see the entirety of its shape. Where the tibia kind of rested on the talus rests on the largest tarsal bone, the calcaneus, often thought of as the heel bone. And you can see it shaded here in orange, and you get an appreciation of really how large this bone is. If you think of this bone compared to any carpal bone, it's, you know, you could fit almost all the carpal bones right here on the calcaneus. And if you think, when you're standing up, a lot of that weight ends up kind of resting in that calcaneal region. You can also see it here from this medial view, and notice this bump that leads into kind of this robust region right here. And this is where the calcaneal or Achilles tendon will attach. All right, excellent. Thank you all so much for your time and attention here. And please always feel free to reach out with any questions.